So now, Stephanie, we've talked a lot about the lower anchors, and I think you have some examples here for us.
Right. I thought people might like to see what's inside the car. And that's, they can feel these metal pieces to which you attach the lower anchors. But this is what's welded into the car. Now, because I'm using this as a demonstration, I'm showing you different styles of these, but you would never put two of these lower anchors on a single bar. Never do that. Always one. But we have several different types. This one, you know, uses a release.
Why is that? Why is the rule no, not two? And it seems like people would want to because it's twice as good, right?
Well, there's a lot of force being put on this. And when you use the lower anchors, that's what's holding your child's seat in the car. So if you put too much force on it, it could crack. Because okay. The forces in a crash are tremendous.
So it's pulling twice as hard.
Because you've got two heavy things, both with the kind of force of the speed of the vehicle. So at 30 miles an hour, you just measure the weight and child that you have on each one times 30. Then you get pretty high pretty quick. Plus sometimes, of course, even if this would take all the weight, you're crowding the space and it may not be holding properly. So when you take this type off, you push it toward the back, turn your wrist and pull it out. It's much easier. A lot of times people just try to do this and they keep hitting. So toward the back of the car, sideways, and then bring it out. This is a push type. Looks kind of like I always think it looks kind of like an alligator. Mm-hmm. So be sure the nose of the alligator's on the top. This is an example of what it looks like inside the safety seat. You've got the two ends here, the adjusters on one end, so that you can adjust the length of this. And then we have some more styles, different ways of releasing and tightening. And so there are a lot of different types of equipment, but all of them have the same purpose, which is to attach the seat to the car without using the safety belt. Not because the safety belt is not strong enough. A safety belt's designed to take the weight of a 200-pound man in a car crash. So you can always use the safety belt. But this was meant to make life easier for parents, and it does work very well. Be sure to use it only in the designated locations in the car. And that's that vehicle owner's manual that you need to get out.
And then also, when they're not in use, they need to be
attached
properly.
Proper stowage is.
I can't imagine getting hit by that.
Well, I have to say that we did have a child whose top tether strap was not properly stowed. It came around and it imprinted on her face, the end of the tether. So it should have been attached, but not only that, if you weren't going to use it, it needs to be properly stowed. Everything moves in a car crash.